Ready to dance on the shore.
And he paid a price.
Bishop's climb back up from the canvas may inspire him. DeAndre Bishop, that training really paid off. Just back to bases. One, two, boom, boom.
Come on.
The other day when we were talking to Andre Bishop, he said to have success in this fight, I have to land combinations. He landed a good one there. Good doubling up of the jab by Mike Tyson. Andre Bishop's blocking ability is doing well for him there. What role can the fans play on the fighters, the atmosphere of the arena, when they know there's two guys meeting up that can bang?
An immature fighter, a less experienced fighter, can get caught up. He can try to satisfy the audience. That's a quick way to be going to the shower earlier than you wanted to.
Landing two jabs by Mike Tyson. Committing to the body work now. He lands the right hand. From Iron Mike. Not getting it done with that straight right hand. And we come to the end of round number one. Tyson's knockdown scored in that last round has a certain tone in that corner that every trainer wants. They are bubbling with confidence. They know they can go out and accomplish things again here. Nice block by Andre Bishop. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Andre Bishop. Andre Bishop's out there for another round after being knocked down in the last round. We know what happens in the 60 seconds with a fighter who was damaged. But what about those 60 seconds in the opposing corner, Ted?
You know, Joe, that's a great question. And I always remember my mentor, Customato. When we were training fighters, he used to always say, look, you know you're a banger, and this guy happens to be a banger. Well, if you hit a guy clean, you know you hurt him. But he's not going to show you. He's going to act like a pro. He's going to con you. He's going to act like that didn't hurt him. But you have to remember, hey, it hurt him. So go after him like he showed it, even if he's not showing it.
Halfway through round number two. That is exactly what the corner wanted to see, a good combination punch by Mike Tyson. He missed by a mile. That wasn't even close by Andre Bishop. Fires off that hook.
Just like that.
The final minute of a round that feels like 30 minutes, not 3 minutes.
And this is the kind of fight where you just don't want to have a loser. They're both winners.
There's the combo to the body. Target, he lands a straight right. Final 10 seconds, round number two. Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Mike Tyson's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Well, with the right hand. And now committing to that midsection as the target with the combination punching. Andre Bishop will need to do more of that. Bishop is very conscious of the fact that he does not want to get tagged hard. He blocked well there. Andre Bishop's work in training camp is now paying off. Do you see the accuracy and the effectiveness with that combination? Tyson's getting himself into the mix now, landing that left hand. Now he places that hook right to the body. To the head he goes with a left hand. Very nice work with the double jab up top. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. How about that left hand? Zoning in on that gut combination punch downstairs. A headshot block. This is what Andre Bishop talked to us about. He said, if I could target any one punch, it's going to be that big hook. Well, hit the target that time. A huge right hand from Mike Tyson. Bishop's at his best when the combinations are landing. He scored well there with that combo.
Keep moving around the ring. Keep moving.